And fans, welcome back. We have got the continuation of this Cruiserweight Fatal 4-Way Ladder match. It's been hellacious so far. We've seen lots of crazy things happen. Got Stephen Clark, the guy with a big disadvantage, is actually defending it against three other guys in this match. And all the three other guys, Koby Johnson, the British kid, Ian Mitchell, all wanting this title belt. And Michael, it's just been hellacious so far, hasn't it? It's just been out of control.
Definitely, and we already seen British Kid get busted open. And I mean, you know, you got weapons laid out all over the ring, two ladders. I mean, these guys are just taking it to the extreme here in this matchup. All four of them wanting that coveted Cruiserweight Championship. And you know, we were talking earlier about the British Kid. I mean, he was the only HCW Featherweight Champion. And we just saw Ian Mitchell just get busted open there by Koby Johnson. But British Kid's the only featherweight champion. He wins the title, never defends it. Title gets retired. And so now he feels like he's out here to try to prove himself here tonight. He wants to prove that that whole title win thing, you know, wasn't a fluke. And he's got a good opportunity right now as he's at the top of the ladder trying to pull down the belt.
Right here.
Here we go.
Yeah, but that's the thing, that's Stephen Clark here. Stephen Clark is trying to kick the ladder underneath. If anything, he should climb the other side to try and get him down. Because there we go. Look at this here, British Kid now.
Oh,
falls,
man.
Straight to the floor.
Yeah, he fell right on that chair, too. He's going to be out for a moment here.
That's what I was going to say. A lot of people, when thinking about a Cruiserweight Championship, they do not think of it as such a high-stake prize here in usual wrestling leagues. But on HCW, it's a really high-stake prize for all our Cruiserweights. It's like their equivalent of, I mean, this may sound stupid, of their World Heavyweight Championship. I mean, the Cruiserweight Championship means a lot on HCW, unlike most other wrestling leagues.
Exactly. I mean, you take these Cruiserweights who range anywhere from 135 to 175 pounds, you know, and I mean, like you said, this is their version of the World Championship, because you're not going to see very often a 145, 55-pound man beating up on a 350-pound man for the World Championship. It's just not going to happen. And now we're fixing to see something here. Stephen Clark and the British Kid both at the top of the ladder exchanging blows here.
Saying it's going to be deadly, but look at this. What the hell is Stephen Clark thinking of doing here?
Oh, my God. Now, I don't know if you
British
saw
Kid
that.
Could be dead.
Well, I don't know if you noticed this or not, but as Stephen Clark was coming down, Ian Mitchell caught Stephen Clark in the back of the head with a 2x4. I mean, that,
oh
to me,
God,
that was unreal.
And now look at this here. Look at this thing. Got Koby Johnson and Ian Mitchell fighting up on top. I mean, Stephen Clark standing there trying to get composure, maybe. They got the British Kid outside, barely moving. And Stephen Mitchell fall down there.
Yeah, we got Koby Johnson now. He's trying to pull down the belt here. Stephen Clark seizing the opportunity here to try to rise up to the top and grab the belt for himself. I mean, there's a sense of urgency here in the mind of Stephen Clark, because any of these three guys can climb out that ladder, take that belt, and Stephen Clark goes home, you know, empty-handed here tonight. And he just threw Koby Johnson off the top of the ladder here, and that was actually a smart move.
I was going to say, nice setup. Another ladder, and look at Ian Mitchell, this DDT British Kid down to the mat. I mean, now look at this arm.
Oh,
first
man.
Right
into the ladder.
Face hit the ladder.
God.
Yeah. Damn. It looks like Ian Mitchell there with that kick to the back of the head now is suddenly taking off all the advantage here. What the hell is Ian Mitchell planning on doing here? Look at this.
Oh, man.
Pile driver. Damn. That's the thing. It's like, all of these men are trying to go for this title. They're trying to pretty much just destroy each other here.
Well, they're playing it smart. They understand. They know the risks. They've got to take out and decapacitate their three opponents before they can try to climb the ladder. And right now we see the British Kid, all three guys out. British Kid extending to the top. He's got that belt.
This is the advantage here. This is what's going to do it.
And now Ian Mitchell's climbing up the other side. And this is where it's going to get very, very dangerous.
This here, and oh, British Kid falls on the ladder, lands on Ian Mitchell on the way down.
Gosh, next. These guys are unbelievable, man. Ladder falls on his ribs, and he just gets up like it's nothing, and now he's climbing back up again. I mean, it's like I said, the sense of urgency in this matchup is just like none other that I've ever seen. These guys just know that any moment one of them is going to climb the ladder and pull down that title, so it's like they feel like they just gotta hurry here. Now we see Koby Johnson, Ian Mitchell exchanging punches at the top of the ladder. And oh man, British Kid tips the ladder again.
As a ladder hit on the ankles of Koby Johnson. I mean, what you got to remember is though, Koby Johnson's return match to HCW was a ladder match against Abdullah Sheikha and the Lizard. So Koby Johnson's got the ladder match pretty much in the bag. But I think really the big concern about me is the smallest guy in this match is the British Kid, and he's been taking these high falls. I mean, at his height, as small as he is, the fall will be seem much bigger. I just don't know how the British Kid can go through this.
I don't know. He's young, he's charismatic, you know. I mean, he don't have any history of any, you know, injuries or anything, so I mean, he's able to go with the flow, I guess. I mean, he's here tonight to prove something. He wants to prove that his title reign that he did have wasn't a fluke, and the only way he can do that is by beating these other three men and claiming that Cruiserweight Championship, taking it into HCW 2.0. And man, Stephen Clark just takes out Johnson there, and it's like I said, all four of these guys trying to, you know, set up that ladder.
Say now all three of Stephen Clark's opponents are down. Stephen Clark, in most probably in this match, has got the biggest disadvantage. In a match like this, the champion will always have the disadvantage. Look at British Kid there, he slipped over on the ladder there. Does not seem right. I think the blood's getting into his eyes here.
Could be. Oh man, and right now the British Kid and Koby Johnson both out. Now Ian Mitchell takes out Clark. And Mitchell now, he's got an opportunity here. If he can just set that ladder up in the right spot here. Here we go now.
Look at this,
British Kid getting back to his feet.
British Kid is up.
And Stephen Clark.
This match has just been unbelievable. Our cruiserweights are just amazing to see. Wait a minute, look at this. Oh, Stephen Clark gets a kick to the face by Koby Johnson. It's just unbelievable.
I'll tell you, this is an incredible matchup here. And I mean, these guys have been literally going at it now for well over 15 minutes. I mean, we've got two guys busted open, and they're both at the top of the ladder just wailing away on each other. One of them trying to get that distinct advantage here, and it looks like Ian Mitchell. Well, no, he went to try to toss British Kid, and British Kid reversed it.
No.
Oh, man, this doesn't look good. Oh, man.
Damn.
I think that could be it for the British Kid here tonight, honestly. I mean, that was a very, very nasty fall. I mean, it looked like the back of his head hit the top of the turnbuckle post on his way down. I mean, he is out.
I think the night is ended for the British Kid. I think the Fat Lady has some for British Kid right here. He's not moving at all. I think we need to get someone down to check the British Kid out.
Definitely.
He's not pain. But look at Koby Johnson here now. This could be his big chance.
British Kid's up now. He's holding his arm, though. He's holding his arm. He definitely could have dislocated a shoulder or something here.
He's holding his ribs also. Wait a minute, look at this here.
Oh! God, no.
Damn.
Who's going to win this match? I'm telling you, I can't call it. I really cannot tell right now who has the advantage. I mean, you think the British Kid's out, and he's right back in there again. He's got the ladder. All three opponents out, and he's climbing up the ladder again.
I think the British Kid has got this here. Look at this now. He's holding on to that Cruiserweight Championship belt, but Ian Mitchell is back up yet again, and that's Stephen Clark. Is none of these men want to lose. They're pretty much going to end up killing themselves here.
Exactly. I mean, this is definitely a career-ending matchup here. I mean, four guys, and now look at this British Kid finally.
Look at this.
Returning the favor to Mitchell. Oh, man. And look at British Kid busted open Koby Johnson.
Wait a minute now, look at Stephen Clark though up here. Look at Stephen Clark, he's holding on to that belt. British Kid, what's he doing? He's trying to get round.
British
Wait
Kid.
A minute here, look at this.
Oh man, British Kid, he just couldn't do anything. Oh man, he couldn't get over there in time.
Stephen Clark retained there, maybe picking his spot. He was standing around for Ian Mitchell and British Kid to fight on top, and he picked his spot and he retained. God, this is just unbelievable. Stephen Clark, ladies and gentlemen, retained his Cruiserweight Championship here tonight in most probably one of the hellacious matches we've had here tonight. Speaking of hellacious matches, we still got the Elimination Chamber to come. That's going to be later on tonight. In fact, we have got to go to another break, and we're going to continue with the finals of the Tag Team Tournament. Fans, stay tuned. We'll be right back. Stephen Clark has retained.